or that I'm not judgmental. I think this diversity business, you know, having a workforce comprised of equal percentages of men versus women, gays versus straights, blacks versus whites, Latinos versus everybody else, it's a crock. And it denies the humanity of everybody you tend to put in a group. I would think you're going to assemble a workforce of employees. You would go find the best people you could to get the job done. And understand that not everybody's going to get along. And the idea to make everybody get along, this study proves it doesn't prove out. Yeah, you're satisfied that it's okay. Every woman wants to be in an office with only women. Fine. But their productivity goes down. Is that a big mystery? You need tension sometimes. You need competition. You need friction now and then. You need an edge. But diversity for its sake, I mean, that's political correctness. That's the New Age movement. That's multiculturalism. That believes, I'll tell you what it manifests itself in. It manifests itself that only women can represent women in politics. And that if a man is a member of Congress from District A, that he's not going to do a nearly as good a job representing the women there. The women are going to think they need a woman. The black's going to need a black. The Hispanic's going to need a Hispanic. And that, my friends, flies right in the face of what this country was all about from the days of its founding. And this push for diversity is a myth. It doesn't lead to what everybody thinks other than outward appearances. It gives the illusion that we're fair, gives the illusion that we're balanced, the illusion this or that, but it totally denies the individual human characteristics of everybody involved. If your objective in putting together a group, be it employees or whatever, is based on outward appearances. That seems to me common sense. Okay, so they've done all this work on diversity, and they've convinced everybody that the greatness of America is our diversity, and they found people and they mixed and matched them, and then they found out it didn't work. It found out that when they let women and women work with only women and vice versa, men only with men, productivity down the tubes. Everybody got along, ostensibly, but productivity went down the tubes. Is that hard to understand why? Not to me. There's so much denial of basic human nature in liberalism that it becomes absurd. The site says here, the findings do not surprise Ann Litwin, a Boston organizational development consultant. Litwin said that in the workshops that she's conducted, people commonly revealed that they are more comfortable with co-workers of the same sex. Men complain they have to walk on eggshells around women colleagues, she said, out of fear of saying something that women might find offensive. They feel like their equilibrium is being thrown off, and it's uncomfortable, said Litwin, who is the author of the recently published New Rules for Women, Revolutionizing the Way Women Work Together. Women, however, say they have to fight to get their ideas noticed when the office is crawling with men. So men complain about having to walk on eggshells. Women feel like they have to be assertive to be heard, and then when they're assertive, they get accused of being a bitch. Is this not age-old stuff? Nothing new here. It's age-old, and it takes me right back to this book that I wish I could remember the... I'm going to have to find this by virtue of a deep search of my email files to find this. You can plaster the name of the book in front of me, and you can plaster the title, and it wouldn't ring a bell. I'm going to find the email of the person who pointed it out to me. That's the only way I'm going to be able to find it.